What's going on, YouTubers? I apologize for yesterday. The enemy's doing his job. So you know what? I'm walking in my greatness today, unbothered. So if this go through, this is meant for you. I have already said with the ancestors, I am the voice of the voiceless. Talk to me, spirit. Those that are new to my channel, thank you. I appreciate the love and support. I love comments. Please like and share and subscribe. Monday, today is Friday, June 3rd. So Monday, I will be announcing the winner of the Egyptian deck that I'm going to be sending out. It's a very powerful deck. Also, Spirit and the ancestors want me to let you know, this is the month of victory. This is the sixth month. Starting this month, June 3rd, 3 is a powerful number. You're going to start receiving your cornucopia. You're going to start receiving your blessings because you have waited patiently, and now you're going to get rewarded for your patience. All right, just hold on, grasshopper. You can't rush the process. Remember, less is more. It's always quality over quantity. Slow wins the race, all right? It's going to happen when God said it's time. Sometimes y'all are around people and they don't deserve to get a piece of the pie that you get ready to receive. God is going to make a way for you. Some of y'all are going to be moving to your own place secretly. This is going to be done when the other person's at work or the other person is gone. It will be done. Some of y'all are going to get approved. Y'all have bad credit. Y'all don't think y'all going to, but Spirit is saying you're going to get approved. All right. Some of y'all need to apply for food stamps. Spirit said you're going to get the food stamps. Don't be ashamed. Let go of that evil pride. Food is food. Some of y'all are going to run across a car, and Spirit's going to say, I'm going to bless you with that amount of money to get this car. A lot of y'all are going to get a lot of blessings. We're going to do pick a pal. I'm going to do 3 pals. Concentrate on which pal you want. If it resonates with you, I am happy. If it don't, this is not your story. Book a private reading with me, and I will help give you your story. All 3 might resonate. 2 of them might resonate, and just 1 might resonate. You never know. You know, don't knock it until you try it. Check out my website. I offer spiritual products. My products that I make, I connect with your ancestors, okay? Each of my products is uniquely different. So when you book a spiritual item from me, I ask permission to tap into your energy. So my money oil, my enchantment oil, my Baron Samedi oil, my Santa Muerte oil, my ancestor oils, all my candles, all my soaps, all my baths, herbs, and stuff like that. I pray over it. I put shaman energy in it, Reiki energy in it to bless you, all right? And it's going to work for you. But you have to be open to receive, and you have to set your intentions, all right? Let's get into it. Talk to me, spirit. What messages do you have for them on PAL 1, ancestors, spirit guides, spiritual ancestors, ancient ancestors? Also, June 19th, the veil is going to be thin. You're going to be feeling the presence of your ancestors more. They're going to be coming to you in your dream. Some of y'all are going to start seeing them in your mind's eye. You're going to have a lot of paranoia activity. PAL 2, what messages do you have for PAL 2? Don't fear what's already a part of you. They didn't choose you and pass down your their wisdom for you to just sit on it, okay? They didn't cry in those fields when they was getting whipped, picking sugar cane and cotton, crying out to you and say, our ancestors is going to free us. Yes, they were singing and praying about you. For you to sit there and not acknowledge your gifts and the wisdom and knowledge that they gave you is a slap in their face. One more for PAL 3. Woo, okay. The energy's strong, PAL 3. One card for PAL 1, spirit. Woo! Thank you. One card for PAL 2, spirit. One more for PAL 3. Once again, thank you for the love and support. I really appreciate it. Y'all don't understand. I really do. I'm letting y'all see. Okay. Messages for Pal One Spirit. Spirit wants y'all to use y'all gifts. Y'all got a lot of gifts. A lot of y'all should be sitting prettier than what y'all are, because you feel like people are going to reject you. They rejected Christ. You know, they rejected your father. You was made in his image. So you're going to get rejected. You know what I'm saying? You chose this path. You chose everything that you're going through because you said you can defeat this. You're not weak. There's nothing weak about y'all. Anything for Pal 3? That's the enemy trying to tell y'all that something's wrong with y'all. They said go back. Anything else for Pal 1? Thank you. Pal 1? Shit. For Pal 2. Anything else for Pal 2? For Pal 3. Show me clearly. Anything for Pal 3? Anything else for Pal 3? One for Pal 1. One for Pal 2. One for Pal 3. Can I get one for Pal 3? All right. This is going to be the final message. The final message for Pal 1. Final message for Pal 1. What is the final message for Pal 1? One more card. Final message for Pal 2. Anything else for a final message for Pal 2? Ashe, ashe, oh, for Pal 3. Final message for Pal 3. Final message for Pal 3. Anything else for Pal 3? What I say, this is your year for you to reap benefits. This is your year to taste your cornucopia. This is your year to taste how juicy your fruit is, juicy fruit. This is your year to reap good seeds. Your patience is being rewarded. Your obedience is being rewarded. This is your time. From this month all the way to December, everything you're asking for, well, not everything, because some of y'all are asking for stuff you shouldn't be asking for. That married man is not yours, and you're not going to get that married man, that married woman. Some of the stuff y'all asking for is going against the spiritual law. So scratch that off. But all those that's wanting a new job, new home, new love, new baby, new car, more responsibility, your dream coming true, you're going to get it. All right? Let's get into Pal 1. That's Pal 2. That's Pal 3. Let's get into it. For Pal 1, you're going through a financial and material change, all right? Some of y'all are going through a financial losses because you're spending on things you shouldn't be spending. Instead of spending it on things you need, you on what you need, you're spending on things that you want. And Spirit is saying no. So they get ready to put you in a timeout in your spending habits to control you. That's an addictive habit that y'all shouldn't have. Some of y'all are just getting readings after readings after readings. And Spirit said you don't need that many readings. Some of y'all are buying clothes and shoes and stuff that you really don't need. And Spirit is saying to stop these purses and things because y'all trying to keep up with the fashion and you hurting yourself. All right, Spirit is saying this is a time that, like I said, the veil is going to be thin on June 19th. Y'all need to go in solitude and meditate. Cover your head when you meditate. This is your covenant. This is your sacred space because your ancestors is getting ready to come down and set some boundaries. All right. Some of y'all are forcing y'all spiritual beliefs on people. Some of y'all are forcing it, say you gotta do it this way. You supposed to be no. That's spiritual bullying. All right. What worked for you might not work for them. What works for them might not work for you, okay? They want you to start showing it out of love. You can chat, you can tell somebody something out of love without being too forceful and too bullying. So, you know what I'm saying? They want you to start showing love and being humble, all right? Revolutionary, you may fight the power. You can ready to start stand up. You are a warrior. You are she mating. You are getting ready to start taking back your throne and leadership because there's people in your soul tribe that's searching for you. So your ancestors are going to come down June 19th and tell you this is what's going to happen. This is what's going to take place. Some of y'all are going to be dreaming about it because it's time for you to rise. Rise to the top. Rise above the ashes. You are that phoenix. You're changing. You are no longer on the tatas, all right? Stop being on the tatas. It's time for you to step. Build up your confidence, okay? You constantly saying, why this ain't happening? I should be doing this. But you keep sitting down and crying over. You want some cheese to go with that wine? You got to start doing something. You first make the first move. Your ancestors, God and your ancestors make the second. You have to start releasing that control. You can't control everything. Especially in the spirit realm, you're going to lose, all right? You're going to have to surrender to God, your higher self, and your spiritual team. Spirit is saying someone or something is involved, okay? Whatever you asking for, whatever you wanting is coming towards you. Whoever you want wants you to, and it's going to be through a third-party situation. Also, Spirit is saying there's two people talking about you, trying to turn the third person against you. The Spirit said that person thinks highly of you. It's not going to work. Those two people that's bad-mouthing you is getting ready to get done back to them. Spirit is saying you are a snake charmer. Turn a situation to your advantage, all right? Stop looking at the negative part. Start looking at the positive part and flip it around to benefit towards you. You got enemies. So that means you need to step up to the plate. You need to do protection around your home, your apartment, around you and your children, your car, your job. You need to spiritually protect your business. A lot of y'all just doing it in the earthly realm and y'all forgetting to do it in the spiritual realm, as above, so below. So you have to protect it on the spiritual realm too. A lot of y'all are going to come up with a divine intervention, which your ancestors are going to start giving you recipes that's theirs, all right? When I say ancestors, it's not always the blood of your blood ancestors. Sometimes there's ancestors that died. They didn't have no one to leave their legacy to, and they chose you. So they going to give you, for example, Madam C.J. Walker. Some of y'all going to be visited by her because she's going to teach you how to do an ointment or something to make your hair grow. You know, alopecia, something that's going to make your hair grow or things like that, some type of product. So like I said, she could have chose you because she didn't have any children really to leave a legacy to. All right, Spirit is saying you are a seeker. You're a seeker of our truth. You are a seeker of natural thirst for wisdom and knowledge. Ask God to tell God you're thirsty for his wisdom and knowledge. Tell God to break it down to you on a four-year-old level so you can understand. Ask and ye shall receive. You know what I'm saying? Don't automatically think it's going to happen. Again, free will. Y'all got to understand free will. A lot of y'all are sitting there doing nothing because y'all not giving your spirit guides permission. You're not giving your guardian angel position. And some of these deities, gods, and goddesses are not going to go against your free will. So they looking at you like, duh. You know, they hear you complaining. They hear you asking, but you're not giving them permission. You have the Ace of Swords and you have the Strength card. The truth is getting ready to be revealed to you. On June 19th, expect a major change. You're going to be different. Like I said, you get ready to reap your benefits. But they want you to go in solitude. All right? They want you to go in solitude to get these benefits. Start journaling more, Pal 1. All right, Pal 2. Pile two, the universe is about to reveal the truth to you. The universe is about to reveal who's your friends and who's your foes. Spirit two, the universe wants you to become one with God, one with your higher self, and one with your spiritual team, the Holy Trinity. They want you to walk in your truth, speak the truth. You are the truth. You are the light. You are everything. The truth is going to set you free, and a lot of people is free. Your job is to speak the truth, is to plant that seed in that person. Don't worry about it if they receive it or don't receive it. Your job is to do your job, and you're going to get blessed for it. Reason why your manifestation is not going the way you want to, because you got to use that childlike imagination. That's why spirits go to children. Okay, that's why when you was a kid, you used to have a childlike imagination. Spirit is saying you need to get back to that. People might call you childish. Fuck them. You know what I'm saying? You're doing this for you. This is going to benefit you. Your friendship with animals, communication with nature, spirits, get out there. Okay, Spirit is saying some of y'all need to go in the trees and in the wilderness, find a tree and become a friend with that tree. You're going to be doing earth magic with that tree. That tree is going to be your spiritual partner. That tree is going to help you manifest the things you want. The tree that is calling out to you, right? You're going to bring fruit or anything like that or some money to get thanks. But a lot of y'all going to be doing earth magic and y'all going to have a tree. This is your tree that's dedicated to you. You're going to start speaking to that tree. The tree is going to start speaking to you. Y'all need to build a bond. You're going to go to this tree all the time, all right? Once again, the underworld, June 19th, y'all going to have a lot of spiritual activity. The veil is going to be thin, all right? You are the seeker. Hold out your hands to receive. A lot of y'all are givers, but you need to be able to receive. While you seeking for wisdom and knowledge, it's going to get poured down to you. So make sure you connect with nature. I'm telling you, y'all need to connect with a tree. I have my own personal tree. Y'all need to learn, okay? You of the earth, earth magic. I'm going to start teaching about earth magic. But right now, I need y'all to find a special tree. And you're going to bond with that tree. That tree is going to trust you, and you're going to trust that tree. So y'all going to have to bond, okay? Spirit is saying continue to walk away from those naysayers, those Debbie Downers. So those people that's also always gossiping about somebody. Because Spirit's saying, if they talking about you, baby, trust me, they telling somebody else your business. See, they don't tell nobody their business, you know, but, you know, that's lowering your power. Speaking negativity, that's lowering your power. That's lowering your defense. That's lowering your, you have cracks in your casita, which means it's have cracks in your aura field, so make you quicker to get spiritual attacks. Spirit is also saying, while you walking away, the people that you lose, you're going to gain people that's going to be helpful, that's going to trust you, that's going to love you, all right? You are getting rebuilt from the ground up. Once you get rebuilt, you're not going to be the same. So you might as well say rest in peace to the old you, because a new you is coming. Oh, you can overcome anything. Don't stay there in a puddle of a negativity, all right? Spirit is saying stop. You have gone into battle so many times, if you have won, all right? Embrace your dark side, embrace your enemies, and know you are an overcomer. You are very strong. You are a she maiden and a warrior. You have three, you have the Ace of Pentacles. What did I say? Earth magic, connecting with the tree. You're gonna make the money, baby. You're gonna start seeing things happening to you, because Mother Earth is your mother. God is your father. Mother Earth is your mother. So go back to your mother and get to know her nature. There's tree spirits in there. There's gnomes. There's elves. There's fairies. There's all type of stuff. There's ancestors there. So you're going to get drawn to this tree. You ain't walking your cornucopia. You're going to meet someone that's going to help you. Not for your money. This person's going to already have money, and they're going to help you. This person is going to spoil you. Yes, a woman can spoil her husband. So this is male or female. All right. But also, they want you to know you have to sit in your talents. If not, they're going to go to waste. Only God can take your talents away. So when it's your time to transition to him, you want to go before him empty, not full, because he's going to ask you, all right? Pal three, you're going through, you in your feelings, pal three. It's because things are not going your way. You always in a hurry. They teaching you to be humble. They teaching you to be patient. All right. Once you do that, because something is leaving your life. It could be a death that's getting ready to happen and you feel it. It could be a relationship that's getting ready to end and you can feel it. You can feel like you're getting ready to get fired off a job. You know something's going to happen. Baby, you have to go through this storm right now. This is what they trying to do, to teach you patient, to teach you humble. They about to break you. Something tragic had to happen in your life for you to eagle, die, and spiritually die for you to live. You have to die before you can live. Once you go through this, this is going to make you stronger. This is going to make you more sensitive. You're going to be like, no, I remember what happened last time. Okay, your heart is so cold from these people that hurt you, but God won't let you hate them because you more than hate. Hate takes too much energy. All right, just know God says vengeance is his. You're going to be rejoicing because the battle is already won. God won. Yeah, the battle was already won. Okay, the enemies think they winning, but the battle is already won. That we already know the ending of it. Continue to be patient. Like I said, if you keep rushing the process, they're going to make you wait. All right, take this time doing your patient waiting. Take this time in your delays and start planning. Do spirit boards. Do vision boards. Start doing a blueprint of how you want your house. Start building your husband, your wife, you know, mentally and also physically. All right. Because like I said, somebody is, I've sensed death around somebody. Somebody in your family is going to die. Someone you know is going to die. A relationship is going to already end. A divorce, a breakup. And this has to hurt. A lot of y'all are with y'all twin flame and he's about to run out of your life and this is going to hurt. This is emotional loss because they trying to get your attention. You're getting too comfortable and it's like you're not doing what you're supposed to do. So this has to take place. Spirit is also saying when you go through this tragedy that you're about to go through, you have a story to tell. You have a testimony. Some of y'all are battling a disease and find out you heal. You don't have it anymore. Cancer. Some of y'all went through an abusive relationship and he scarred you. You have a story. Some of y'all lost a child. You have a story. Spirit says your story is going to help bring a lot of people out of their funk. You are a healer. You are a life coach. You don't understand. Your testimony is going to set a lot of people free. Spirit is saying, pay attention to the trickster spirits. Y'all need to identify. A trickster spirit is going to tell you to go lie to somebody, to go hurt somebody, the 1-800 chokehold. All right, that's a trickster spirit. Also, Spirit is saying, alcohol is called spirits because they invite a lot of trickster spirits. So a lot of y'all are divining, giving people messages, and those are trickster spirits lying and you speaking it out. A lot of y'all getting high and y'all don't know reality. Y'all don't know what's real and what's not real. I'll put it that way. You got to start paying attention, okay? You're inviting trickster spirits in and you're getting fucked up. You have the ancestors and you have the pillar. This, once again, June 19th, y'all going to have a lot of paranoia activity, a lot of vivid dreams, a lot of seeing things or stuff out of your eye, feeling their presence. It's because you have one foot in the realm and one foot in the earthly realm. This is your time. You're going to be walking with the light in the dark. You're going to get a lot of underworld spirits coming. You're going to probably like Lucifer, Baphomet, Beelzebub, Grimoire, Azazel, things like that. Because you walk with the light in the dark, you're going to get visited by a lot of spirits you don't want to get. So this is where you're going to understand what's a trickster spirit and what's not. You feeling defeated. It's because they teaching you to be patient and be humble. You know what I'm saying? You're going through an emotional loss. You feel like you've been forsaken. No, you had to get purged. You had to get planted. You had to die a spiritual death and an ego death for you to live. That's where you're going through. You get ready to rise above this. This is going to make you stronger. This Dractus change is going to make you a new you. All right. It's going to be a destruction of the old and the new you. You had to lose stuff to gain stuff. I hope I'm making sense to you. Pretty soon, because you're going through this change, you're going to feel out of reach. It's like people ain't going to understand you. You're going to feel like, I'm tired talking to people that don't understand the words out of my mouth. It's like you're going to get tired of a lot of old things, people. It's like y'all ignorant. You know, all y'all want to do is gossip. You're getting tired of all that. It's starting to drain you. So you're going to go higher. Some of y'all get ready to get blessed with a new home, a new car, a new business, a new attitude, a new boo. Money's going to start pouring into you because you have always poured into people. So you got to get blessed. And y'all also going to start traveling. And this is going to happen rapidly. All right, let's do the coins. I mean, the charms. This goes for pile 1, 2, and 3. Some of y'all getting spiritually attacked through your crown chakra. You having headaches, y'all channeling. Spirit said you need to learn to turn your light off. Y'all really need to protect your home, I'm hearing. Spirit said if you see a lot of stray animals coming around you, like a dog, a cat, for no reason out of the blue, they taking a hit for you. They letting you know that you getting ready to get on this spiritual attack. Give them something to eat. Bless them because they are warning you. Also, Spirit is saying if you're dreaming about OWL owls, that's spiritual wisdom. Like there's a deity or a god of this is about to enter into your life. Whoever wants to do a shoe business, Spirit is saying you're going to start seeing advertisement of wholesale or shoes business or retail business. That's going to start taking place because it's time for you to step into your calling. Spirit is saying someone's heart is healing. You're getting ready to start receiving love. Someone's getting ready to get blessed financially. Like I said, if you apply for food stamps, get it. Also, Spirit is saying y'all getting ready to get blessed financially. You're going to receive some money offer, some loans, some approval or something, but you're getting ready to get blessed financially. These dragonflies, someone must have fairies. I'm telling you, they're not always dragonflies. The sun is getting ready to shine on you. Step out in the sun. Sun gaze in the sun for like 3 seconds, 3 minutes with your feet in the grass so you can activate your third eye and you can heal. You need that to waken up your melanin. Felicidad is someone's going to find out that they're pregnant this month. Congratulations. Abundance, fertility. If you're dreaming about fishes, that's fertility. Someone's going to be pregnant or going to be pregnant, is pregnant or going to be pregnant. Also, fertility means a birth of a new business, new idea, new love, things like that. Y'all be blessed. Peace. Namaste. Ashe.